I've heard that too with problems, and that's why people say sleep on it.
Yeah. Yeah, you've never been told to stay awake on a problem.
Yeah, it's true, right? I mean, sometimes when you're about to go to bed, it's almost overwhelming. You just can't concentrate on anything else but this problem, whatever it is. And then you go to sleep and you wake up in the morning like, it's all right.
Yeah.
It's going to be fine.
Yeah.
I got it. I know what to do.
And sleep sort of, you know, and there's lots of anecdotal evidence of sleep-inspired creativity. And now this shifts to one of the benefits of dreaming, in fact. It's during dream sleep when we take all of the information that we've previously learned and we start to collide it with all of the new information that we've learned. It's it's a little bit like group therapy for memories. You know, everyone gets a name badge and you all get to speak to each other. And the brain starts to seek out and test novel connections and new associations. So it's almost like informational alchemy. And you wake up the next morning with a revised mind-wide web that is now capable of divining, you know, incredible solutions to previously impenetrable problems. And lots of anecdotes, you know, Dmitri Mendeleev came up with a periodic table of elements by way of dream-inspired insight. You know, talk about a Herculean task. Take all of the elements in the known universe and figure out a structure as to how they all fit together. Off you go. His waking brain could not do it. His sleeping brain solved the problem.
Whoa.
I mean, Einstein, by the way, this is great. Einstein was suggested to be a short sleeper, and we don't know if that's true. But even if he was, he was a habitual napper during the day. I've got some great pictures of him on his workbench. And he used sleep ruthlessly as a tool for creativity. And he would sit at his desk and he would have a sort of pad of paper and a pencil. And he had a chair with armrests. And he would pick up two steel ball bearings and take a metal saucepan and turn it upside down, place it underneath the arm of the chair. And put the two steel ball bearings in his hand. Then he would rest back and he would start to fall asleep. And so he didn't fall too far into sleep. What would happen is at some point, his muscle tone would relax. They would release the steel ball bearings. They would crash on the saucepan, wake him up. And then he would write down all of the creative ideas that he was having. Isn't that brilliant?
Wow.
So no wonder, yeah, you're never told to sort of stay awake on a problem. And in every language that I've inquired about to date, French, Swahili, that phrase, sleeping on a problem, seems to exist. Which must mean that this benefit of dream sleep transcends cultural boundaries. I should note, I think it's important that the French translation is much closer to you sleep with a problem. We, the British, you say you sleep on a problem. The French, you say you sleep with a problem. I think it says so much about the romantic difference between the British and the French, you know?
Yeah, the French sort of trying to fuck everything. They're trying to fuck their problems.
I'll lose my British passport for saying that, but that's okay.
You won't. I will, but I won't either. It's just a joke. That's fascinating that Einstein figured that out, too, that he literally had like a whole routine that he would drop this ball, would hit it, bang, and wake up and start writing. Like,
self-medicating.
Imagine being in the room. I would love to be in the room watching Einstein do that. It must have been fascinating.
Oh, sorry. I said Einstein. It's Edison. My goodness. I'm an idiot. Edison.
Sorry. Changes everything.
That's probably the
wasn't Edison a thief, though? Didn't he steal everything from Tesla?